I'm just happy that he did not write anything about smartphones before they were on the market. Because then I probably would still have an internet-free old phone with buttons. Hello, and welcome to my channel. I'm Roxie. I hope you're doing well. Today, I want to tell you about this book, The Passengers by John Mars, a best-selling British author and a former freelance journalist. In my opinion, it falls into a category of psychological thriller fiction. It's a page-turner with a philosophical idea behind it that makes you question technology and society. Fun fact about the author: John Mars came with the idea for this book in a conversation with his former editor, who asked him if he could write a story about self-driving vehicles. He liked the idea and created this novel. This book is a bit difficult to summarize because there is so much going on. Plus, this novel is told from the perspectives of 7 characters with different backgrounds, genders, and age groups. So, The Passengers is set in the near future, in England, where the self-driving cars almost fully replaced normal ones which we drive today. Not only are they affordable and environmentally friendly, but the rate of car accidents vastly reduced, thanks to artificial intelligence. Everything is just great, until one day. Something always has to happen if you're reading a thriller book, doesn't it? The day where 8 people became prisoners of their cars and hostages of the hacker who broke into the system. He creates a live stream session online and makes a demand to vote and pick the only one hostage who will win the right to live, and to make the statement that he is serious and won't accept any tricks, he reduces the number of hostages from 8 to 5. A petrified audience has to listen to short interviews with the victims, who do a great job at winning their sympathy. But the hacker interrupts them and reveals their darkest secrets, one worse than another. And he does not give another chance for hostages to clear their name. Who will the audience choose? Will a young pregnant woman get a chance to see her newborn regardless of what happened in her home? Or will a celebrity from the old days be able to continue her charity campaign, although what she did in the past destroyed the lives of innocent people? And will a happily married couple, at least one of them, see their children again and be forgiven for what they did to each other? And can the love of a person save a man who does not value his own life? And finally, why did the hacker do this? Could kidnapping be only a tool to reveal an even bigger secret? I'm not going to tell you. You will have to find it out for yourself. Overall, I enjoyed reading this novel a lot, and I would recommend it to anyone who likes thrillers and mind game novels. It makes you think about so much, especially about technology. Where will digitalization and computerization lead us? I love the way John Mars, in the same manner as in his other book, the one I made a review here, kept constant tension and created mini stories through which you get to know each character very well. Plus, each chapter also ends in the most interesting moment, where you can't just stop. You have to keep on reading, forgetting about everything you have to do. It's definitely not a bedtime read, because it will keep you awake until you finish it. I also enjoyed the way he showed the power of information, how it can be manipulated and how it influences the decisions and opinions of others. It teaches us how wrong it is to judge anyone. Another plus point for me was the ending. Not only it was different from what I expected, but it had a full epilogue, where the author answered everything I personally wanted to find out. I think that John Mars is insanely good at coming up with brilliant ideas for future products and services. Where you first fall in love with his idea, as he illustrates all the good sides of it, and then he debunks it to the level which not only makes you fear it, but creates a lifelong paranoia. I'm just happy that he did not write anything about smartphones before they were on the market. Because then I probably would still have an internet-free old phone with buttons. Mini minus point for me though was that I felt that the time the hacker gave for victims was a bit off. The story, dialogues and everything which was happening seemed to be much longer than the author said. You know, like in the action movies where a timer on the bomb has only 10 seconds left? And during these 10 seconds, the main characters are talking forever, sharing their feelings, emotions, and life stories. So, did you read this book as well? How did you find it? And what do you think about fully autonomous cars? If it would exist now, would you get one? Let me know down in the comments below. I personally think that although humans make mistakes when they drive, I can't fully rely on the decisions of an artificial intelligence. Thank you for watching, and if you like my review, please like it, subscribe and hit the notification button. Also, please check out my stories which I wrote here and other book reviews here. See you soon. Bye.